short course off-road truck racing, if you're going in a truck, you're in with the pros, and most of these guys are seasoned veterans and have championships and have done lots of other styles of racing. So bringing these kids up this young into a professional class, and there really isn't a lot of stepping stone for this type of sport.
You know, for me and CJ, it's pressure because both of our dads have gone out there and they've done so much in this sport.
They got to listen to their dads bitch about each other. You know, Johnny ran into me, and so I'm pissed off at him, and then I flipped him off, and so he's mad at me. Johnny Greaves has showed that he's, you know, one of, if not the best, and honestly, I don't give a shit. I'm here to win.
Well, it's going to be a battle to the end, I think, and I hope if everything's good that it'll come down to showdown in Texas.
The biggest family rivalry in off-road racing is between the Johnsons and the Greaves. Luke Johnson and CJ Greaves compete in Pro Light, while their fathers, Ricky and Johnny, battle to prove who's the best in the Pro 4 class.
Johnny Greaves versus Ricky Johnson.
Johnny Greaves versus Ricky Johnson.
Johnny versus RJ. I'm a little biased to Johnny. I've been teammates with Johnny, and I try to follow a lot of stuff he's done, and he's a great competitor. RJ's a good competitor too, but being a hometown boy from Wisconsin, Johnny Greaves is my vote.
Rick Johnson any day of the week.
I tell you what, I think they're both gonna trip and Adrian Cheney's gonna win.
They're both very competitive, they're both very fast. Johnny has that younger, inspirational push it in the turn. If I go on my lid, that's the way it goes. Ricky has a smarter driving style to get out in the loose stuff and get bite and work the track more. He's more of a bull.
Johnny, he's from Wisconsin. He's a cheesehead like you.
Both very tough competitors. Been good friends with both of them at different times. Battled Ricky. Had my run-ins with him, so I'll go with Johnny Greaves.
Rivalries in the sport, they've always been there, and it's just a great thing for the sport, for the fans and everything. But when you have two young kids, you know, the sons of two championship fathers, and these two fathers are racing against each other, I mean, what better drama and rivalry could you ask for? You know, me and Ricky are going to end this all one day and be the two fathers in the grandstands drinking beer saying, my kid's going to beat your kid.
Johnny's a champion, I want to kick his ass. I like the guy as a person, I have a world of respect for him, but he's the guy with the number one plate, and for me to show my worth as a driver, he's the guy I gotta beat.
I think the rivalry is off the track and drama that gets hooped up on it versus on the track. It's always good competition when you can have a little bit of that going on.
Especially when you have two energy drinks.
Competition itself, it's Monster against Rebel, but it's also Ricky versus Johnny. I mean, they've been doing this since before the energy drinks were even around. So that rivalry goes way back, and they just now transfer it to who they're racing for right now.
Winning is always good. It doesn't get any better than winning. That's all you have to say about it. Oh! I can't even explain defeat. It is hard for me. I'm a very competitive person, and I have a guy that has a career history of wins and championships.
As Johnny says, like a UFC fight, you're fighting for everything you got because this is my life, this is his life. You know, if I beat him, I'm taking food off of his dinner table. He beats me, he's taking off of mine. So I'm going to fight for my family and my respect as much as anybody. So I got to respect him for that when he comes in hard on me and races me hard and banging me around and doing all the different things.
Fueling the rivalry even more is the fact that Ricky and Johnny are atop the Pro 4 standings, with RJ holding a slight lead over last year's champion going into Charlotte.
When it comes to defending a championship versus chasing one, Ricky's, I think he's just sitting in a pretty good seat because he's new to the class, he's got nothing to lose, and he wants to prove that he can come in and do this. And if he doesn't, you know, if he gets second or third, everybody's going to go, well, you know, we didn't really expect you to win right away. But, you know, I've been in this class since 2001, and I've dealt with, you know, Rob McCaffrey's and Walker Evans and everybody who's came through the ranks, and I've learned how to handle it.
I'm that simple redneck that just wants to drive.
Really? That's news to me.
And Ricky's been the Pro 2 talent out there forever. Him and Rob go back and forth on who the heck is the best one out there in that Pro 2. And now he's in the Pro 4, and I thought it would take him a little bit, but it isn't taking him anything. He's already got it dialed, and he's nipping at my heels. And, you know, I think, you know, whatever these guys got to throw at me, we'll figure out a way to deal with it.
In Pro Light, Luke Johnson and CJ Greaves are constantly reminded of the rivalry between their fathers and the rivalry that creates between the two of them.
The fan part of it's cool to see people come and say, oh, we came just to watch you. We came to watch you and Luke race. We came to watch your dad and Ricky race against each other and just see how it all plays out.
Last year, my dad winning the Pro 2 championship and now getting into Pro 4, and CJ stepping up from the Super Buggies, getting into the Pro Light class, has made it interesting now that it's father versus father and son versus son. It's definitely created a little bit more tension around the pits, and it's actually kind of cool to see two generations racing against each other at the exact same time each weekend we go out to the races.
They are the sons of champions and guys that have done a lot. To fill those shoes is going to be tough. I mean, between Ricky and Johnny, they've won a lot of races, and it's going to be tough shoes to fill for sure.
I would think CJ and Luke probably have the most pressure of anybody here, because they got legends for fathers, and no matter what you say, that's mentally in the back of your head at all times.
Having a champion as a dad is, I mean, awesome. He's got, I think, more championships than anyone else, and it's like learning from the best. I mean, you can't ask for anything more.
Well, I've taught him right, because he said the right answer there. I mean, let's face it, one day I'm not going to be able to maintain the level and the sponsorship and everything else, so if we want to keep doing this, we got to have plan B, and it's plan B. When we were getting his driving suit made, they said, do you want to put anything on it? I said, yeah, on the back, put 401K.
I had to hold on to something. And then I pulled my head up.
With CJ and Luke, it's just a neat deal because they both kind of dropped into it about the same time, and me and Ricky are competing in the same class, so here comes the next generation. It just so happens those two boys are, you know, in the same class, so everybody's looking at him and watching, you know, who will be the next Ricky Johnson or Johnny Greaves.
With Luke, it's, you know, he's starting out, and there's the pressure of everyone's looking at him like he's going to be like him, and so he's got that pressure. He's got pressure because he's a new driver.
We got pictures of him when he was a little kid, got walking around with my helmet on, and you know,
he would take his shoes off and put them right next to Rick's. From the time that we can remember, that's what he wanted to do.
They'll come back from trips, and it's like they're just best friends. It's crazy. I'm almost a little jealous of it that I don't get to go on trips like that, but it's a beautiful thing.
Radio hot mic, woo! I better not fart, you'll hear me.
When Ricky and Luke run, I'm proud because they're part of the team. But when Bryce runs, you know, that's your son. There's a different level, and I can't explain it. It's like hillbilly heroin or whatever you want to say. It's truly, truly exciting.
Beat them. I think if you hit your kids a lot, they
beat them. Benadryl.
Benadryl, shots of vodka in their milk.
No, we've always, you know, since we've had them, they've all flown since they were 2 weeks old. They came into our lives. We didn't go into theirs. So they were just on board.
The biggest thing we do is we don't rush him. We don't push him. We kind of let him run his pace. And we don't want him to get burnout on it or lose interest. We want him to have fun with it. And I mean, he's 16 years old, so he's got some great opportunities. Both those guys do, and then you involve, you know, one's got Red Bull, one's got Monster, and you know, it is the perfect little mess we are in.
Luke and CJ do talk. They're not best of friends, but they are acquaintances. They're not button heads or anything, but you know, they're good competitors, and they have a lot of sportsmanship for each other.
Right? We're friends to an extent. I mean, we're competitors. You know, he's not someone, you know, we go hang out on the weekends and stuff. He kind of has a hots for my sister.
They're buddies, and he's always texting her, come down here, and she's like, no. So, you know, she plays hard to get at the track.
They do hang out. I've even wondered that myself. I'll ask her all the time. I'll be like, so are you sure you and CJ are just friends? And she'll be like, oh my God, Sam, yes, I've already told you. But I know Luke wonders too. It's just funny hearing what everyone says about them.
He's got a long line of men to go through to get there.
Yeah, long line of.
He's got like Jake, then Luke, then me.
If he breaks my little sister's heart, then we're gonna have some problems.
If he can pass the test, I'm all for it.
No, they're good friends.
She's a smart girl, and I know she'll make the right decisions. Stay away from the Greaves.
Oh, no, we're in Charlotte. It's pretty wild to be here. The heart of NASCAR land, the heart of racing. They're building us one barn burner of a track, and we're going to put on a heck of a show, that's for sure.
Here is, I think, is monumental for when it comes to the TORC series and short course off-road truck racing. So I think you're going to see all aspects. The big trucks are going to go fast. We're all going to be banging. Track conditions are awesome. The obstacles are awesome. Let's go race.
The weekend's first battle between the Johnsons and the Greaves would take place between Luke and CJ in Pro Light.
Luke Johnson and CJ Greaves battling it out one more time into that tight left-hand 180 into the infield. CJ Greaves getting a little loose, bouncing up a corner, and just, oh, left rear tire's gone.
Yeah, it's just a weird deal. The studs snapped flush off in the rear drive plate on the rear axle housing, and you know, we've never seen that before, but I guess it's time to get better parts.
The battle was short-lived for both. Luke and CJ experienced mechanical failures, and neither finished the race.
Charlie's got work to do tonight.
Five different gears. Nothing.
Transmission broke. It's bad for him. You know, Luke is kind of down on himself because he qualified 10th, but my heart's broken for him. I'm his dad. I hate to see my son out there because I know what it feels like, and I know how bad he wants it. You know what I mean? The kid does anything and everything possible because he just loves racing. So I hate to see him sit on the sideline. It just breaks my heart.
You're all good.
Alright,
try to out of
it tomorrow and let's get it done.
I need to put my big boy panties on tomorrow and get after it because I was kind of pussyfooting it around out there, and that's not what gets wins. And two DNFs in a row is definitely not good for us, but now that means we just got to go for wins. That means I got to man up and get after it.
Being sent to the stands early had to be disappointing for Luke and CJ, but at least it gave them a chance to get a good seat for the premier event of the evening, the Pro 4 race featuring their respective fathers.
A little nervous that he's next to Chinny.
Welcome to Charlotte Motor Speedway Race fans and Pro 4 at the line.
Green flag for Pro 4x4 with Ricky Johnson starting on the pole.
Outside of him, Adrian Chinny in row one, falling back to second. Johnny Greaves in third.
All right, let's just settle in here, run some good clean laps, Rick. Let's nail this corner up here. Roll it up there, free it up, Rick. Nice job. Oh, nice job. Clear by six, clear by seven.
You know, I knew coming in, this is Ricky's forte. He's the man when it comes to slippery tracks and throttle control and finesse.
RJ continues to lead over Chinny. And trouble for Chinny now as he pulls off the track. That's going to move Greaves up into second.
What happened?
Power steering down.
Yeah, Chinny just blew this corner down here, Rick, so you got a whole bunch of room between you and Greaves.
Ricky Johnson got off to an early lead, a lead he would hold until the competition yellow at the halfway point in the race.
you know, after the yellow, I was in second, and I tried to hang with him, and you know, I beat up my gearbox a little bit.
Under, go under. Good job, good job. Greaves is close. We are on the podium right now. Greaves is going slow, so we have to finish. Greaves is coming back. Something must have shut off.
One time it jumped out of gear and I didn't have any gear, so I decided I'm gonna find one gear and I'm gonna leave it in that gear, and I gotta bring this thing home.
Mark Jenkins comes inside of Scott Douglas. They make contact across the line.
Hey, get away from me. That's slow. Contact is slow.
Come on, calm him down a little bit.
Just got one from TORC. Just got a warning. Contact is slow. Got a right front flat. That contact you had flattened your front tire. Cannot contact that with your tires like that, Mark. You are fast right now. Right front is flat.
Jenkins with a right front flat tire, heard from Kenny Kincaid. But he still looks like he's at speed as Jenkins is still trying to reel in Douglas.
Easy, easy, you're too fast in that turn, Mark, damn it.
And Ricky Johnson takes the win here in Pro 4x4.
Go, bud.
Ricky Johnson will take the win and will increase his points lead just slightly over Johnny Greaves in the championship chase.
I definitely paid the price. I mean, Ricky had his stuff together and ran a great race.
With Scott Douglas and Mark Jenkins battling behind him, Ricky Johnson took the checkered flag and increased his points lead over Johnny Greaves.
Good job, Mark. The tire got flat from contact. That's where we took ourselves out. We were faster than Douglas today. You would have definitely beat him.
Hell of a deal, yeah.
I rolled out of it.
Yeah, okay, yeah.
Are we good?
Yeah, we're fine.
Yeah,
we're fine, man. Don't worry, there'll be a time. We'll see if we're good.
That's what I had to do.
Not a problem. Not a problem, man. Good job. Good driving, Mark. We'll get to the front. Good job.
Congratulations, Ricky. Point leader,
race winner. You gotta be feeling pretty good right now to be on top.
Yeah, this is the first
victory for that Mending Motorsports Pro 4. Yeah. Getting
faster, faster each week. This is our first win, and then hopefully
it's the first of many. We survived, and some days that's what you're here for, is to survive. And yeah, it was a fourth, but it's better than a DNF, and we're still in the points, and it's still a long season. I'm not too worried. I mean, I've been in a lot worse situations.
Yeah, my motor was falling down.
A new day meant a new race, and after posting DNFs the day before, both Luke and CJ hit the track determined to redeem themselves.
My dad, you know, sat me down this morning right before breakfast, and we just kind of talked about where I was at mentally after yesterday and where we needed to grow from there. And coming into today, I had a whole different outlook. I was a lot more positive, a lot more confident.
CJ Greaves started in bad fashion as he took out Trax's teammate Sam Hubinett early in the race.
Up in third gear. Boom!
Payback's a bitch.
You will see it. You're not paying the bills. I'm not paying the bills. He's paying the bills. And he got money.
I've left now.
Sam watched his truck and his race go up in flames as a result of CJ's rookie mistake. Sam promised there would be payback when they met again. But CJ's focus was on the rest of this race and fighting for position against Luke Johnson and the rest of the ProLite field.
Two of our youngest drivers now battling for position, CJ Greaves and Luke Johnson. CJ defending Super Buggy champion from 1 year ago, now in ProLite, and Luke Johnson with a strong motocross background.
When it comes to me and CJ, I'm gonna give him the same amount of respect he's gonna give me. If he's gonna rub on my door, I'm gonna rub right back. You know, I'm not gonna just roll over. It
takes two to tangle. If you're gonna start it, someone's gonna end it.
Luke's gonna have to step it up to Park River to run with this boy.
Despite starting the race in last, Luke secured a top five finish for the first time this season. CJ finished in ninth. but that was good enough to stay ahead of Luke in points. Now it's time for Ricky and Johnny to teach the best way they know how, by schooling the rest of the Pro 4 field.
Let's kind of assess it. Let's just maybe stay put for a little bit.
Copy that.
This is one of those situations that they may sort themselves out just because they all get the hero thing going.
Copy that.
In the green, let's keep them 2x2 side by side. Got a long race, let's keep them clean. Get your drivers calm.
Well, here we are, race fans. For the first time ever, we are in NASCAR country, Charlotte Motor Speedway. As we look out on the track right now, the big guns, Pro 4, ready to take the green flag.
We're going for a win tonight, boys. Keep me queued up and whipped up as necessary. But we want to go.
Ready. Ready. Ready.
Green, go, go,
green,
go,
green,
go.
Green, 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 green.
Green flag is out, we're underway. Finally, Pro 4 is on the track, what everybody's been wanting to see. First time ever been here in NASCAR country, Shane.
Mike Jenkins had the inside on the front row, and he'll have the advantage here early on, and he's got Barlow with him.
In a tight track around a half mile, the dirt track here in Charlotte. When the track is finally built, about 0.8 of a mile in length, off-road style.
Hold it, hold it, help. That f***ing axle's done. They're fired. They're the same f***ing thing.
You're exactly right. Knocked it out.
Man f***ing knew, both of them. I called him today and f***ing got on him about it. F***ing joke.
So trouble early on for Mike Jenkins, who had the pole, and it looks like Johnny Greaves will have the lead early on.
Early in this race, everybody's dicing for position as fast as they can.
Speed up coming off, still there. Still there, clear, 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 clear. Clear by half. Looking inside, you should get him off the exit here. Barlow, get out of the way, on your left. Ricky on your back bumper.
As Ricky Johnson moves up another spot, going around the number 25 of Mark Jenkins. And side by side, once again, looks like Johnson, though, will hold the advantage.
And how about Steve Barlow? Good run going for him earlier in this race in that Mental Militia Ford.
Johnson now begins to mix it up a little bit with Mark Jenkins as they come back out onto the front straight.
Three wide as they enter into turn one of the oval. Ricky Johnson dives down low to the inside. Now watch these Ram trucks. Both Bryce Menzies in Pro 2 and Ricky Johnson here in Pro 4 handle the corners a little bit differently than just about every other truck out there as they make contact. Barlow and Johnson make contact.
Move down, spotters. Long range, long range. Keep your drivers calm.
And that was communication over the radio from our USAC official, Jason Smith, telling the spotters, keep the drivers calm. There's a long way to go in this one. They're running 22 lap races here this weekend. Saw some heavy contact there between Douglas and Jenkins.
Number four back. Down low, he's coming around you down low. Pick it up, come on, get him, get him, get him. You're clear. Down the corner.
Now Douglas goes to work on Barlow as they head back down into the infield around that tight left-hand corner, and Jenkins in the mix as well. Three, four, and five running nose to tail.
Barlow likes to really throw that truck sideways in the corners, almost block the entire corner. No other line available for other drivers around him, and that's what really upsets guys like Scott Douglas. They're always making contact.
Scott, as our field makes the way around the racetrack, you can see one of the issues that they're dealing with as well on the track, and that's visibility. Some places very well lit, others not so well lit, and dust comes into play as well.
And there's also two different kinds of track surfaces out there. You got the oval, which is clay, infield, black dirt. Everything is constantly changing. You hear it all the time in off-road racing, dirt track racing, the track is constantly changing lap after lap.
Johnson got a great drive on Greaves as they headed down the back straight, side by side on entry to that left-hand corner.
On your right, set him up here, bud. Still there.
And it's starting to materialize already, the Johnny and Ricky show, something we've been watching all season long, and it's already starting to happen right in front of us right now.
Just settle in, Rick. We've got a lot of time here.
Watch him coming in this corner. He's going to go inside. He's inside. He's inside. Oh, get him back. Come on, let's go get that guy.
A nice pass to the inside by Mark Jenkins. And got inside of Steve Barlow just enough to force him to the outside, gave a clean track to Jenkins, and he makes the pass very nicely done.
And Ricky Johnson once again charging hard into the left-hand hairpin. I don't think he's found the line that he likes to run quite yet. As you see 3, 4, and 5, Barlow after dropping his spot to Jenkins.
This is easy, Rick. Just let's try to find a good spot here. Just settle, get it up to him.
But of course, Johnny Greaves, one of the hardest guys in the business to get around. As it's still almost nose to tail heading into stock car turns number 1 and 2, Johnson looks down to the inside now.
You got such great comparisons between these two drivers, both former motocrossers.
Still there, careful.
They're both very accomplished off-road racers, and now they're taking all that knowledge, all their expertise, and putting it up against each other.
Side by side for a moment. Now Ricky goes outside in on Johnny Greaves. A little bit of contact.
Still there. Clear. Clear by one.
And Ricky Johnson completes the pass on the outside as they enter onto the front stretch. Greaves goes inside, trying a different line altogether. Nothing is there. Johnson now our new leader.
Greaves falls back down to second. Of course, these guys also came into the weekend first and second in the points chase.
And now, not only do we have competition between Toyota and Ram, we also have competition in tires. BF Goodrich and Maxxis. All these things are going on. It's who's got the right setup for this race tonight.
Greaves comes charging back, looks inside for a moment on the right-hander on the infield. Johnson doing a great job of playing defense, though. Nothing doing there for Johnny Greaves.
And now Greaves is going to town on Ricky Johnson. He is watching where he's going, where he's fast, where he's not so fast. Now Greaves is watching Johnson and his line.
One final time in the first half of this race as they go through the infield right-hand hairpin. And Johnson actually stretching his lead a couple of lengths over Johnny Greaves.
One last time, entering onto the oval in turn 4, coming down the front stretch. Ricky Johnson will have the point as the competition yellow. Johnny Greaves will cross the line in second.
That's our halfway caution. Nice job. Couple 15 breaths here, Ricky. Doing fine.
Night had fallen in Charlotte by the time the competition yellow came out, and it was Ricky Johnson and Johnny Greaves that the lights were clearly focused on. Pro 4 Field drove in orderly fashion behind the Ram Pace truck, knowing that once the green flag fell to signal the restart, order would turn to chaos.
Ricky Johnson on the point, Johnny Greaves running in second, and I hate to say all eyes are on those two guys as we've got a stacked field behind them, but right now, the way the season has been going, as we get ready to take the green flag, that's exactly what everyone's watching, the top two drivers.
Johnson now takes the field as they come out turn number 4, green flag.
In turn 1 and 2 of the oval, here comes Jenkins to the inside, gets a little squirrely on Douglas. Douglas goes way wide to the outside.
Jenkins moves up into third. Johnson, however, holds the lead over Greaves.
And you know what? We talked about the Johnny and Ricky show. Well, guess what? We have got the Mark Jenkins and Scott Douglas to watch as well. As now, Douglas is going to be a little ticked off, and I'm sure coming back after Mark Jenkins.
And we've seen these guys mix it up before, going back to last year at Bark River when it all started.
Whoa. You all right? Me over. Adrian.
Steve Barlow gets sideways through one of the infield turns. Oh, check this out. Scott Douglas gets into the left rear of Mark Jenkins.
Get in front of Douglas. The yellow come out, full course yellow. Take your position back.
We have got a ton of issues going on right now.
Let's see if we can get a black flag on that one. That was solid.
Don't give it up, no matter what. Do not give it up.
You can hear Mark Jenkins clearly unhappy with the move that Douglas made to get back around him.
That left rear tire, is that a flat? I may have a flat on the right side. I may have maybe losing some rear brake fluid.
Hey, spotters, we did not complete. Back to the lineup of the competition. Go back to the line of competition. 7 is ahead of the 25. The truck we went yellow for is the 83. He'll be on the tail.
Got to give it up, Mark. You got to go back. You got to go back one position. Let Douglas have it. It's going back to the competition caution. We didn't complete a lap, and that is the correct call.
He spun me out to get the position on purpose.
Spotter on the 25. He needs to back up. 7 is in that position.
Cue up his spotter. Shit comes back around. Let him know.
Spotter on the 25. I also expect you to calm your driver down immediately.
Hey, you guys better get in the hot pits.
We're here, ready and waiting for him.
We're ready.
I have a flat. Do I need to come in?
Yes. Go in. Go up along the outside wall. No, no, you can't do that. Get on the outside, Mark. They waved it off. They waved it off, guys. They waved it off. Hurry up. They're going to give us a lap. Stay in. They're staying yellow.
That was bullshit. They held that whole deal up for the 25 to get a tire and come back out.
It's got all kinds of controversy here during the competition yellow.
And green flag is out. Mark Jenkins in the hot pits, but crossing the line will be Ricky Johnson at the point. Johnny Green, Scott Douglas, Adrian Chenning on the top four with Barlow in fifth.
And immediately, Johnny Greaves goes to work on Johnson as they go down the backstretch.
And once again, the Johnny and Ricky show is playing out. Johnny goes to the inside line. Now watch closely. Both drivers are trying different, slightly different lines everywhere on the racetrack, trying to find out what worked for them.
On your right, on your right. Still there, clear by half, clear by half. Coming on your right hard, coming on your right hard.
Contact made big time. Ricky Johnson, Johnny Greaves. Greaves will bounce way to the outside. Douglas comes inside. Greaves comes back to the inside and will retake second spot.
Yeah, but in spite of all that contact and all that drama, no change in the running order. It's still Ricky Johnson out front, then it's Johnny Greaves in second, and Douglas still in third.
You got to keep in mind that left front tire, there may be some sort of damage between the heavy contact between him and Ricky Johnson. So as the race wears on, keep an eye on that left front.
Crowd is loving it right now as Greaves once again closes the gap on Johnson.
Ricky Johnson swapping sides back and forth, trying to maintain the lead, and hopefully for his sake, maybe even extend it some.
That gap holding pretty steady between 1 and 2 as Johnson holds the advantage still over Johnny Greaves. Down to the turn number 1 and 2 section of the course, looks like about 4 car lengths between our leader.
As our top 3 trucks head down the backstretch, again, they pitch it hard into that left-hand turn. Douglas right there trying to make up a little ground on Johnny Greaves. Ricky Johnson through the double jumps, now through the rhythm section, set up for that tight right-hand 180 into the infield. You can see the ruts now almost 2, maybe 3 feet deep as they bounce their way through there. Johnny Greaves trying to make up some kind of ground on Ricky Johnson in the last portion of this race.
Scott Douglas still in third, of course. He had that heavy contact earlier on with Mark Jenkins, and Jenkins pretty much out of contention at this point, well back in the pack after having changed a tire, as Douglas is still running in third. Yeah, time is running out right now for Johnny Greaves. He's basically got to pull out all the stops as Ricky Johnson has been dominant after about the third lap.
Our top 3 trucks once again working their way through the infield. Ricky Johnson tiptoeing through the corner. Johnny Greaves right there as well.
Looks like Greaves able to make it through those jumps a little bit more smoothly than Johnson. And there he shows a wheel to the inside.
3 laps to go, spotters. 3 laps to go.
3 laps remaining as the gap continues to close within 1 truck length now as they come through turn number 1.
You can see the way the tires are folding underneath the wheels are going into the corners. And now we got smoke out of the ram of Ricky Johnson. Smoke just started to appear right there down the front stretch.
Trouble for your leader as Greaves now. There's blood in the water.
Something smoking here, Rick. I don't know if we want to be alarmed about this. Clear by 3.
And you hear Charlie Schliebe doesn't really know what's causing the smoke out of the truck of Ricky Johnson. As Greaves looks to the inside.
2 laps to go, clear by 2.
Again, they're going into turn 1. Johnny Greaves now right at the back bumper of Ricky Johnson. Johnny is right there!
bumper to bumper as they go through turns number one and two down the backstretch. More smoke pours out of the back of the Red Bull Ram of Johnson.
And it's clearly now the Ricky and Johnny show as they've both lost the sight of Scott Douglas.
And Johnny Greaves now putting a ton of pressure on Ricky Johnson, heading for the right-hand infield hairpin.
RJ looking so smooth inside that truck.
On your right.
And they make contact over the jumps.
Dallaire.
Up to the tabletop. RJ lands on top of Johnny Greaves. Into the final turn. They tap each other coming out. They're still both going.
Go get him. Get on their sideline.
They're side by side on the front stretch as we check out the replay. RJ actually lands on top of Johnny Greaves. They make contact in the air, come down on top of Johnny Greaves. He slides to the side without touching his helmet. The visor pops up, pops back down all on its own.
Still there. Take the highliner on here. Yep, hold on to it. Still there. Show him something here, Rick. Show him something.
As if we're watching the world of outlaw sprint cars, it is Steve Kinzer and Sammy Swindell. Again, more contact with the infield. Greaves now has the advantage. Greaves goes inside.
Johnson tries the outside in, shows a wheel. They're side by side momentarily, but Greaves noses ahead.
For a moment, Ricky Johnson taps the back bumper of Greaves again. Now the final turn.
Johnson driving hard to the inside. More contact as they come to the line.
And across the finish line, taking the win will be Johnny Greaves.
Ricky Johnson across the line second.
And finishing a hard-fought third will be Scott Douglas.
And the crowd here in NASCAR country absolutely loving it. They may have just seen one of the greatest off-road races of all time.
Without a doubt, Shane, you nailed it with that comment right there. As Johnny Greaves and RJ pull up alongside each other. There's the thumbs up. A very happy Johnny Greaves, Ricky Johnson, and then Scott Douglas in third in a very worn-out truck. And right there's the man of the hour.
Love this truck! Yeah!
That was the most intense race I've ever been in, and you know, I raced Ricky a lot, and he's a gentleman, and the gentleman went away once I started showing him inside. I knew that one time he swapped off the jump, I'm like, all right, he's not willing to let up, and then I finally pass him, and I feel the thing land on my back and flip over the top of me, or drive over top. I'm like, are you kidding me? And we're still going. Man, if the fans didn't get their money's worth that time, I don't know where else you're gonna get it, because you ain't find that in stock car racing.
Hey, throw them up! Hey, little boy, if you're big enough before you bring it, take a shot. Go,
wait,
take it.
I want to explain. Yeah, it was a good race, but you landed on his wheel.
I'm going straight.
All right.
I didn't touch him. He's flipping me off.
How old are you?
I didn't touch him.
You got to thank Monster Toyota. You know, Max's tires, my family, crew, everyone that came here, and there's a fight.
Never gonna touch him, but he can't sit there and do this to me. He's gotta learn. I'm never gonna hit a kid. He's flipping me off. He needs to learn. I'm not gonna beat up a kid. That's not the point. I'm not gonna beat up a kid.
For you, bro. I went straight off the jump. No, he flipped me off. I came out and I talked to him.
I flipped you off too.
I know that. Then come talk to me. All I did is I went over.
Go after him.
I didn't go after him. I said you need to think about what you're doing before you do it. I'm not gonna hit your kid, bro. Don't make a threat because I'm not gonna hit your kid. That was never
the
intent.
I hope you got more brains.
I got a lot more brains than that. And when I landed on you, I was going straight. I will. I'll go apologize and hug him. I think the kid's a great kid.
It was a good race.
It was a good race. You came back, you fought back, and I never once turned into you. When I landed on you there, I was going straight for the corner.
Dude, you were swapping so many times and you never lifted, but whatever. I probably did the same thing, right? We're ready for the win.
Congratulations. You're the best driver tonight. You drove a good, you drove a good race. And I will apologize to you.
I don't want to repeat.
I got it.
I know.
It's
a good win. That's the way it's supposed to be, you know. He gave these fans a crowd, a show, and, you know, I thought Ricky probably was a little aggressive there. I raced him pretty clean, but in the end, it was gloves off, so.
Congratulations.
Hey, John.
Anyhow, we're racing hard. We're banging back and forth. And I got into Johnny. You know, I was swapping. I was trying to hold on. I was trying to go straight. You know, CJ, his son's pissed off at me because I landed on him. He flipped me off. And so I just went and have a talk with him. I'm never going to punch a kid. I mean, he's a kid. I love the kid. He's a great racer. He races with my son. And Johnny and I are going to be doing this all year long. So, Charlotte, I hope you like this. I mean, love me or hate me, that was a hell of a race, you know. So, they cursed Jimmy, they cursed Earnhardt. Hey, I was racing as hard as I could, and I was not trying to take Johnny out. So, hey, it's racing, emotions get high, but I never hurt your son.
You know, both them guys want to win. Neither one of them want to lose. So, you know, it is what it is.
Obviously, Johnny and I had a slam-bang race. I landed on him, and it seemed to piss everybody off.
I knew he was going to have a good battle by the time he got up to Johnny, and he got around him pretty clean.
I got alongside him in that section before that, and he was swapping sideways, and I went off the jump, and I had wondered if he was gonna lift or not, and he didn't, and he hit me and sent me, you know, way off the track. So then I went back after him, and I passed him back, and I knew I definitely had him cleared.
He got to the inside of me, I came around, I knew he was to the right of me, I swapped when I landed, I overcorrected, and then when I was in the air, I landed on him.
You let up for that jump so you can set up for the corner. If you don't want to let up, you can jump way farther than you want, and that's exactly what he did. He just tried to jump either past me or on me or whatever.
So I landed and bounced and swapped, next thing I know, sliding backwards, I hit the gas, and I start going at it.
All I remember is that I heard a big crash, and my head, you know, went down real violent, and I honestly thought we were flipping through the air because it was all quiet for a while, and all of a sudden I see his truck kind of skidding off my hood and down my front bumper, and I'm like, he just landed on me, you know, and there he was sitting sideways in front of me, and, you know, my first instinct was just to drill him. But my second instinct was just to beat his ass, and that was the better one.
Pissed his kid off, CJ. I came around, he had the bird flying at me, and in that state of emotion where I've been fighting that hard and everything, for a kid to jump out and flip me off and think that it's going to go unrecognized is just wrong. And I have a little respect for him as, you know, as a little racer and stuff like that, but as a man, if you're going to do something like that, you need to be ready to step up. So I jumped out of the car, got right in his face, and said, if you're mad enough to flip me off, then take a look at it.
You're big enough before you think to take a shot. Go! Take it!
If he even hit me, I would never hit a kid.
I didn't touch him!
Ricky Johnson isn't used to getting beat. That's why he did what he did, is because, you know, it eats him from the inside out to get beat, and he's in my ballpark right now, and he's definitely a player, but it's not going to go down easy. It never will.
What was I aiming for you, bro? I went straight off the jump.
Ricky Johnson and Johnny Greaves weren't the only ones exchanging words after the race.
Went over. Go
ahead. No comments. I'm going to play the best for tonight. Maybe another day.
I just was standing there, and Kathy came up to me and poked me in the chest and told me that, with a lot of profanity, that she was going to kill Rick if he ever talked to her son like that.
Were you there? What happened? Yeah, I was there. He, like, slammed on the brakes, CJ flipped him off, jumped across the walk, had him up against the fence, and had, like, four people holding him back. He was, like,
because you flipped him. He's such a poor sport.
He said, yeah, it was a good race, but you landed on him. He said, I'll you're going straight, and he's hollering. He's like, I'm standing right here. Take your best shot.
Rob Mack.
I'm like, relax. I'm not going to get you.
Ricky and I probably still have a little war to settle here, and it may go on for the rest of the year.
Johnny's threatening me about other races and stuff like that. I know, Johnny, you're going to run into me. Let's go. Get it on.
Thank you.
was fun to watch, man.